I mentioned many akhbar like this. We want to take the summary or the benefit of all that. We're not trying to now make judgments on these things. From that point, the eyes were open on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The eyes were looking upon him, and I mean in a very, not in a very casual way. No. And you see that in the seerah of Abdul Muttalib. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam's dad died. Who took him in charge? Who was in charge of him? Abdul Muttalib, his grandfather. Abdul Muttalib was no ordinary man. Yani Abdul Muttalib was a man who was Sayyid Quraysh, the master of Quraysh. Not only the master of Quraysh, Sayyid al-Dathha, but Sayyid al-Rabi'ah al-Mudhar. The entire Rabi'ah al-Mudhar belonged to him, are subjugated by him. Basically, the entire peninsula. Abdul Muttalib. Huh? Abdul Muttalib gave a special care and special orders that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam be taken care of. So much that Abdul Muttalib himself in his old age, when his little grandson comes, 2 years old, walking to him, he would stand up and he seats him in his own seat behind the Kaaba. Huh. And he would, then when they would ask him, Ya Abdul Muttalib, you are the master of Quraysh, huh? Little kid makes you, he says, إِنَّ لِإِبْنِي هَذَا شَأْنٌ عَظِيمٌ. This my grandson will have something great, will have a great shan, huh? Shan, some matter that is really great. Anyway, so much that when the Prophet ﷺ grew up a little bit more, a few couple of years, 4 or 5 years, what is the habit of people who are 3, 4, 5, 6 years old? They play with other boys, right? Boys, they play with boys, they do things. But there were things about the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that was not like that. He was not playing with the other boys. And he was going with the sheep, he was going to the mountains, he was looking at the skies, he was looking at the moon, he was looking at the sun. He was making comments that people is not really of his age. You did not see him playing with these boys like this, etc., etc. You saw him always secluding himself from these things. Huh? Saying things that people say, what is this? Where did you bring this from? Huh? Going to the mountains, going to that, etc., etc. So much that because of his statements, and I don't want you to be amazed, saying, what are you talking about? Is that possible? We'll talk about that when we talk about Isa in just a minute. Now, so much that Abdul Muttalib, he assigned people to guard him. He ordered Abu Talib, Abu Hamza, Abu Jahl, Abu Lahab, and all the uncles of the Prophet وسلم, says, assign some of your kids or some people, the young people, to guard him wherever he goes. Be careful. One time the Prophet وسلم slipped, he went away to the desert, to the mountains, في شعاب مكة, and he was late coming back. He lost his way back to Mecca. Abdul Muttalib is waiting, still in the reign of Abdul Muttalib. Abdul Muttalib is waiting. What happens? Where is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? He calls Abu Talib, he calls Abu Lahab, he calls this, he calls Hamza, he calls Al-Abbas. Nobody knows. He says, فَلْيَمْتَشِقْ كُلٌّ مِنْكُمْ حُسَامًا. Every one of you, call all Bani Abdul Muttalib and Bani Al-Fadl. All of them. All Bani Hashim, Bani Abdul Fadl, Bani Abdul Muttalib, call them. They called them, all the people came. Hundreds of people, everyone take their sword, he told them. Take your sword, put your hand on your sword, and go out in the desert. Look for Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If you do not see him, you go and fight every tribe of Quraysh until they say where he is. Of course, Abu Talib went in the desert and saw, after looking, saw the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam sleeping under a tree. He was overtaken by sleep under a tree in the middle of nowhere, sleeping there. He woke him up and he took him back. That's what the surah talks about. Alam yajidka yatiman fa awa wa wajadaka dhalan fa hada. Alam yajidka yatiman, didn't he find you orphan? Weren't you an orphan? Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, yes, he was an orphan. Alam yajidka yatiman fa'awa. He provided what? A place for you, a home for you to stay, the home of Abdul Muttalib. Fa'awa. He gave you the house of Abdul Muttalib to stay. And after that, of course, the house of Abu Talib. Wa wajadaka dhalan fahada. And he found you lost. And he took you back. not violent like some people nowadays say. Right? Because some people say, well, the Prophet was dal. Walayyadu billah. Dal meaning what? Misguided? Yeah, mushrik. They meant by that he was mushrik before Islam. That he was worshipping idols. Walayyadu billah. Without, how can that be? A dal in the Arabic language, if you look, you say shajaratun dalla, which means a tree in the middle of nowhere. It is called a lost tree. Lost tree because there's no other trees around it. Not because it is misguided, it's because it's lost in its environment. And you can be a rajul dal in the sense that you are a man that of wisdom in the midst of many people who are unwise. In that sense, you are lost in your environment. One Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was not dal in like these ignorance wal ayyadu billahi ta'ala kullum that he was mushrik. If that was the case, people would have no trust in him. He would call them to Allah and they said, well, wait a minute. Yesterday you were worshipping idols and tell us to worship idols. Now today you want to worship something else? Huh? And then we believe that the Prophet ﷺ, they have some asma from shirk before and after. The shirk does not apply to them. Because you see, this is the point. There is a difference between someone who is tahir from tahir, pure from pure, nur from nur, sajid from sajid, than someone who's mixed in shirk and kufr and then becomes Islam, Muslim. No problem. Allah forgives. But the essence is different. وَتَقَلُّبَكَ فِي السَّاجِدِينَ النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أَسْطَاهِرٌ مِّن طَاهِرٌ pure from pure, ساجدٌ مِّن ساجد, prostrated from prostrated, وَهُوَ نُورٌ مِّن نُورٌ صلى الله تعالى عليه وعلى آله وسلم. Okay. And then when we said, well, you know, he said these things when he was 4 and 3 and 5 years old, and he said things that were not sort of his other people's age. Is that weird? Is that strange? Why is it strange? Because he was always a prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. From the day he was born, he was a prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Look at Isa alayhi salam. قالوا بعد عقل شكون كيف نكلم من كان في المهد صبيا. The people told Maryam alayhi salam, she's holding who? Isa alayhi salam, newborn, just got born. Huh? And they said, they're talking to, interrogating Maryam alayhi salam. She points to him. Ask him, you're fooling, you're mocking our minds? You are belittling, you are insulting our intelligence? كيف, the Quran says, كيف نكلم من كان في المهد صبيا. How can we talk to someone who's just a newborn? What did Isa say? He didn't say, I'm not a prophet yet. I might do all kinds of things. Until I become a prophet, then I will say. Huh? What did he say? Al Quran says, قال إني عبد الله. Right away he spoke. Isa alayhi salam, Jesus, what they call him, Jesus.